Hey, ladies, did you get a raise this year? Congratulations. But guess what? You're still making less than a man, according to new figures from the U.S. Labor Department. How did that happen? CNN's Stephanie Elam joining us live from New York, who, we won't talk, I guess, about salary here and all. It's all negotiable
it just
in this
makes
business.
You go, well, dadgabbit.
Yeah, exactly. It's like, man, why can't we be on an equal playing field?
Yes, it's like foiled. Yeah, well, Kara, it's true. Yesterday happened to be equal pay day. And in light of that, we've got these numbers from the Labor Department that show that, okay, while it's true that men do make more than women, at least the gap has narrowed. So here, take a look at this. Weekly earnings, this is the median here, men make $844 a week. That's in the first quarter of this year, these numbers are from. Well, women make 79% of that, or basically $665. So that's 79% there of what was being made by men. If you look at the first quarter of 2000, you can see that women actually made 76%, so there has been some improvement. Now, for every $1 that men earn, Hispanic women make 60 cents, black women make 69 cents, white women make 80 cents, and Asian women getting the closest there, earning 90 cents for each dollar. But still, it shows you that there's a huge discrepancy out there between what men and women are getting paid, Kara.
So what are the best paying jobs for women?
Well, you know, if you can just run out and get yourself a CEO job, that might not be a bad thing for you to do. Because take a look at this one, Kara. If you take a look at it based on how it's broken down, weekly pay for a CEO, $1,500, that is about 75% of what a man would get paid in that same role. So you see pharmacist there at 76%, lawyer at 75%, and the best one actually, they keep saying this, technology, IT manager, they're doing the best, getting 79%. But still, you're talking about a quarter of a percentage of money that's going more to men than it is to women. So the discrepancy is still there. A lot of people wonder why this is. Some say it's sexism. Some say that women are more likely to leave the workforce to take care of children, take care of other family members. And because of that, when they do come back, they're behind on the pay scale. But it's probably somewhere in between because it's very hard to actually just highlight exactly what the issue is, Kara.
Yeah, well, it's one of those things I think we'll be talking about for a long time, that's for sure. Well, no matter
what I don't think it's going to change next year.
Yeah, right, exactly. And no matter what you get paid, you're always doing a great job. It doesn't even matter,
right.
Steph. That's right.
Oh, well, thank you,
we'll
Kara Phillips.
We'll lose that work ethic. Thanks, Stephanie.